The blueprint for HAARP, High Frequency Active Auroral Research Program.
What does HAARP do? HAARP is a large antenna where we beam radio frequency energy up into the upper atmosphere, and we create on a small scale what the sun normally does.
The assignment came that the Navy and the Air Force were to manage the program.
Applications discussed in the patents included destroying missiles. Communications control and disruption were included. There were some other ideas, both to possibly modify weather, and finally, to lift a portion of the upper atmosphere further out into space, where hopefully it would be able to deflect missile trajectories.
In 1983, I did radio tomography with 30 watts, looking for oil in the ground. I found 26 oil wells over a 9-state area, and 100% of the time was accurate, which is 30 watts of power beaming straight into solid rock. HAARP uses a billion watts beamed straight into the ionosphere for experiments. Picture these strings on the piano as layers of the earth. Each one has its own frequency. What we used to do is beam radio waves into the ground, and it would vibrate any strings that were present in the ground. We might get a sound back like, and we'd say, that's natural gas. We might get a sound back like, and we say, that's crude oil. We were able to identify each frequency. We accomplished this with just 30 watts of radio power. If you do this with 2 billion watts, the vibrations are so violent that the entire piano would shake. In fact, the whole house would shake. In fact, the vibrations could be so severe underground that could even cause an earthquake.
HAARP can create some of the effects that the sun creates that are similar to the aurora borealis.
HAARP can paint designs in the sky, if you will. You know, it can take the beam and move it in any pattern that you, that the scientist who's doing an experiment might want to do.
这东西是个方向问题，你单机上好像看不到。有光纤的折射膜，太阳折射，就是云彩折射的太阳光幕，应该就是。
Quake struck China. Roll it. Oh my. That's from an airport. That tape comes from a spot near the epicenter of that 7.9 magnitude quake.
China correspondent Stephen McDonnell is in the disaster zone.
At a school where hundreds are feared dead, troops rush bodies away from the scene. Then a rare moment of triumph as a student is found alive. But for most, there's only loss and pain. This woman fainting with grief. At another school, there was more grief as rescue workers fought to free the trapped and injured. At this building, they used microphones to pick up voices and video cameras to find the victims. Eventually, a survivor was freed, but it was a painful escape. China's deputy leader, Premier Wen Jiabao, has been comforting the victims. He told this girl, "Don't cry, the government will take good care of you." As well as strong aftershocks, rain has increased the dangers of the rescue effort,